So students, next we are going to continue with the chemical properties of phenols. So we have already studied some of the chemical properties, like the first one, that is acidity of phenol. Okay, where phenol can react with the sodium metal as well as sodium hydroxide. So by then phenol will be acting as an acid, right? So to give the certain product, salt formation will take place, right? So that is first reaction, and the second reaction, that is nothing but esterification reaction. Okay, so by that time also we have studied the conversion of salicylic acid into aspirin. So that is nothing but in the presence of conversion will take place as an ester, right? So that is nothing but phenolic group only we have taken. Okay, so the third reaction, the third chemical properties under phenol. Okay, the chemical properties of phenol, the third chemical property, that is electrophilic, aromatic substitution reaction. So here, you know, the phenolic group is having OH group, right? OH. So phenolic group, aromatic group will be having OH group. So this OH group is highly volatile in nature. So that due to the presence of this acidic group, the formic reaction which goes with the electrophilic substitution reaction. Okay. So majorly here, the electrophilic substitution reaction takes place in the two position majorly. So that is nothing but top as well as para position that you can identify by writing the resonance structure of phenolic group. So where it will be having in the presence of in the position of ortho, okay, as well as para position, where it will be having more electron density. Okay, so you can identify over there. So where electron density is more, so there only the attack will take place, right? So here the electrophilic group will attack to electron rich group. Okay, so where it is having negative charge, right? So this is regarding the electrophilic aromatic substitution. So here in north as well as para position only the electron will get substituted. So here the major electrophilic substitution reaction, the two reactions you are going to study, that is nothing but nitration as well as halogenation. Okay, so first we will see under this, that is the nitration reaction. Okay, so here you know nitration reaction is nothing but the addition of nitro to be better. Okay, so here you just write down the phenol react with reaction of phenol with dilute nitric acid at 298 Kelvin to give ortho or para nitrophenol. So ortho or para nitrophenol will be formed as a product over here. So we write with the reaction. So you are supposed to take phenol. So phenol will be treated with, in the presence of dilute nitric acid, the reaction will be done, right? So here at the temperature, that is 298 Kelvin, low temperature will be reacted over here, so that you will get ortho as well as para group. Okay, so para nitrophenol will be formed as a product. Okay, then one is with the ortho position, nitro group will be present. So this is nothing but ortho nitrophenol. In the same way, product formation takes place in the position of para. So that is, see, 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 4 position, that is nothing but para position, right? So here, at para position, nitro group will be attached. So that is nothing but para nitrophenol will be formed as a product, and para will be the major product. Okay? So this will be the minor product. And here, one more important question can be asked, that is nothing but how can we separate this ortho nitrophenol as a say, this is the product formation, right? So how will we able to separate these product? Okay, so that kind of question will be asked. So remember, para as well as ortho isomers, if it is present, that can be separated by using of steam distillation method. Okay, so that can be done by steam distillation method. So now here, what will happen in the presence of steam distillation? See, your ortho nitrophenol So due to that reason, see here, if you consider ortho nitrophenol, then it will be having a intramolecular hydrogen bond will be present. So due to that reason, dissociation of the molecule will be easy when it goes with steam distillation. So the collection of ortho nitrophenol will be easy. So here, if I go with the structure of ortho nitrophenol, so that goes with this one, see. OH and double bond O, here O, right? So between oxygen, electronegative atom as well as hydrogen, here bond formation takes place. So within a molecule, we can say hydrogen bonding, in the sense intra, okay? Intramolecular hydrogen bonding will be possible in the case of ortho nitrophenol. So that it goes with the dissociation and these are highly volatile towards the steam, okay? So that we can go with the distillation method over here. Okay, so this is nothing but ortho nitrophenol. So what will happen in the case of para nitrophenol? So para nitrophenol, if you consider, so that will be having inter. Okay, so here OH group will be present and double bond O, here O, and this is one molecule of para nitrophenol, and it goes with another molecule of para nitrophenol. So here OH will be present. Okay. So between this, the bond formation will take place. Hydrogen bond will be formed. See, here within a molecule, intramolecular hydrogen bond is here intermolecular hydrogen. Okay, so this is intra, and here it is intermolecular hydrogen bond will take place. Due to that reason, what will happen? The molecule started associating with one another. Okay, so these are less volatile towards steam distillation. Para groups are less volatile towards steam distillation. These are highly volatile, so it will go with the dissociation as well as you can easily separate with the distillation method. Okay, so this is regarding nitration. How you be able to separate it out? Sometimes you can ask, instead of direct nitric acid, if you use concentrated nitric acid, what will happen? See, we'll go with the reaction. So now here I take phenol. The reaction are considered in the presence of concentrated nitric acid. So in the presence of concentrated nitric acid, what will happen? Instead of getting monophenol, in the sense monogroup as a product, so here product formation will take place as NO2. Trinitrophenol formation will take place. Okay, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 position. Right? So 2, 4, we can write 2, 4, 6 trinitrophenol formation which takes place as a product. Okay? So instead of nitric acid, if you use concentrated nitric acid, this kind of product formation takes place. So this is regarding your nitration. So remember, if you use direct HLOC, a single product formation will take place. Okay, so if you use concentrated nitric acid, kind of the product formation will take place as a product. So this is regarding nitration. So next we learn what will happen with the halogenation. So next, electrophilic substitution, halogen will be acting as electrophile now. Okay, so how the reaction will proceed? So remember, so whenever the halogenation reaction you have learned. Okay, so that halogenation reaction will be done in the presence of Lewis acid. So you have learned till now the reaction of or the halogenation in the presence of Lewis acid. Because if Lewis acid is present, it polarizes your halogen. Okay, so due to that reason, Lewis acid will be used. Iron bromide, all those kind of Lewis acid you are going to use. So now here for phenol, no need of using Lewis acid. Okay. So Lewis acid doesn't require. The reason is here OH group is present, which is very active in phenolic group. Okay, so due to this reason, Lewis acid is not required with this. And here halogenation reaction is nothing but phenol can react with the halogen to give halide kind of product formation in this case. And here the reaction, it goes with a different manner with a different conditions. In the presence of different conditions, the reaction can take place to give different kind of product. Okay, so we'll see halogenation. We are going to learn with the two methods. Okay, so in terms of two conditions, how it will take place, that we are going to learn. That's okay. So now halogenation, first we learn when phenol will be treated with chloroform you can use, or carbon disulfide will be utilized. By that time, monohalogen formation will take place as a product. Okay, monohalogen formation will be the product. Okay, so like CNS. Once again, reaction will take place with the halogen. Halogen is must, right? So halogen in carbon disulfide. Okay, so here when it will be utilized. Like polar compound, if you are using in the sense, you are going to get monohalide as a product. Okay, so here OH. So either in ortho position or in para position, the product formation will take place. So here ortho bromophenol. So this is nothing but para bromophenol formation will take place as a product. So this is one condition. Another condition, instead of this, you can use a bromine water. Okay, directly the reaction can be done in the presence of bromine water. So if you are using bromine water, how the reaction takes place? By that time, you will get a single product. So that is nothing but based on 2,4,6. Okay, all as well as and all ortho as well as para position attacking of halogen will take place. Okay, so here this is nothing but 2,4,6 tribromophenol. Okay, so 2,4,6 tribromophenol formation will take place as a product. Okay, so here this in this reaction you can observe the major bicrystallic formation will take place as a product. So you can observe in the test tube the formation of bicrystallic will take place over here in the presence of bromine water. Okay, so this is regarding halogenation, where electrophile, this halogen group as well as nitro group will act as electrophilic in nature and the reaction will be done. Okay, so in two ways, nitration we have learned, halogenation it can go with in the presence of polar solvents. Okay, like chloroform you can use, or carbon disulfide you can utilize, as well as you can use bromine water. So directly you will get 2,4,6 tribromophenol formation will take place as a product. Byproduct also will be there. Okay, so number of bromine will be 3 Br. If you are using in a cell, 3 HBr will be removed as a product. Okay, so this reaction already we have learned in our lower class lab. Okay, so this is regarding electrophilic aromatic substitution reaction. The fourth reaction under the chemical properties of phenol, that is very important reaction. That reaction is Mass-Cox reaction. Important reaction it is. Okay, as I told, the naming reaction is very important for you people. Fourth reaction, which is known as Cox reaction. So direct question also can be asked from here. Okay, so what is mean by Cox reaction? So Cox reaction is nothing but the reaction of phenolic group, which takes place in the presence of sodium hydroxide. In the presence of a base, the reaction will be done so that sodium phenoxide formation will take place as a product. So write it over here. Reaction of phenol with base NaOH, okay, in the presence of a base, the reaction will be done to give sodium phenoxide. Okay, then the reaction will proceed with the electrophilic substitution will take place. So one weak electrophile we are going to use, that is nothing but carbon dioxide. Okay, so here the reaction will continue with the carbon dioxide. Okay, so right over here the reaction will proceed with the carbon dioxide, which act as electrophilic in nature. Okay, so mild electrophile will be utilized over here to get salicylic acid as a product. So this is regarding Cox reaction, very important reaction. Okay, so now here directly you can take phenolic group will be taken, reaction will be done in the presence of NaOH. Okay, so first what will happen, you are going to get sodium phenoxide as a product, O-N-A. Hydrogen will be removed. isomer related. So sodium peroxide formation takes place in the presence of carbon dioxide as well as hydrogen. The reaction will proceed to give salicylic acid. Formation of salicylic acid will be formed as a product. OHCOOH. Salicylic acid will be formed as a product. So this this reaction is consists of mechanism where the carbon dioxide, as I told, so this will act as a weak electrical. Okay. So what will happen? CO2 groups are there, right? So here it will be phenolic group you are having, which has been replaced by sodium, right? So CO2 group is present. Okay, so here it will be having lone pair of electrons. This mechanism is not important, just for your reference. This will be given out here. Okay, so the bond, the carbon dioxide will get attacked. So this will act as electrified. So this will attack on the carbon, right? So here attachment takes place. This bond will be given, and you will get an intermediate formation. Okay, so now here double bonded O formation will take place, and here you will get C. Okay. C double bond O with O minus and Na plus, what is there? So that will react with this and formation of O minus Na plus will be taking place, as well as hydrogen will be present over here, because this CO2 got added over here, the hydrogen has been removed, so that will be showing over here. Okay, so this kind of intermediate formation takes place again as a next step. So here you are going to give back the H plus addition will take place. Okay, so by that time H plus will be added for this. Okay, so Na will be removed, H plus will be added, so that you will get COOH, and this one will be given back, and this one will be given back to oxygen. So what you will get as a product? So when it will be given back, you will get a bond over here, right? So hydrogen will replace Na, so that you will get COOH, right? So this one is given back to oxygen, so that you will get OH. As a product. So this is nothing but salicylic acid formation takes place as a product. So this is regarding Koch's reaction. Mechanism is not required, just you need this reaction. The reaction takes place in the presence of a base as well as carbon dioxide with a salicylic acid as a product. So this is Koch's reaction. Copy down the reaction. So next reaction. So it is very important reaction, one more important reaction, that is Raymer-Heimer reaction. So the next reaction, fifth reaction, Raymer-Heimer reaction. Raymer, T-I-E-M. T-I-E-M Heimer reaction. This is also a naming reaction, very important reaction. So here reaction will take place with the phenol in the presence of chloroform. Okay, with the presence of chloroform the reaction will proceed, as well as base. Okay, so it will be having base. So there the product will, formation will take place, right? So aldehyde group will be attacking to the benzene ring. Okay, so the aldehyde group will be formed as a product over there. So there the final product, carboxylic acid, aldehyde group only, the formation of aldehyde group will take place as a product. Salicylic aldehyde will be formed. Now, whatever the reaction you have learned, Koch's reaction there, carboxylic acid will get as a product. Here aldehyde group you will get as a product. Okay. So here the reaction will take place with the phenolic group. Okay, the reaction will proceed in the form of chloroform. Okay, as well as aqueous NaOH will be taken. Okay, so aqueous NaOH will be taken. So as I have told, the reaction will proceed to get first sodium peroxide formation takes place, as well as the intermediate formation will be there in the ring. Okay, so here you will get O and A as well as CHCl2. one of the CN will be removed, because when it will attack over here, hydrogen will be removed, right? So that hydrogen as well as CN will be removed as HCl. The formation of HCl will take place. So here, this is nothing but your intermediate. Okay, so this intermediate which is more stable in nature. Okay, so this intermediate is more stable in nature, and the reaction will proceed in the presence of a base. Okay, so the reaction will proceed in the presence of a base to get aldehyde as a product. So directly salicylic aldehyde formation will take place in the presence of a base. Isolated group will be formed first. So now here, isolated group formation will take place as a product. Okay, so O and A will be there in the presence of H. This and the replacement of this will take place, as well as you will get OH CHO, salicylaldehyde. Okay, so formation of aldehyde. Salicylaldehyde will be formed as a product. So this is regarding Reimann-Friedmann reaction. So where we can identify phenol will react with chloroform in the presence of aqueous and UV. By that time, hydrogen will be replaced with Na and H will go as H2O molecule. And here CHCl will attack to this carbon. Okay, where hydrogen which is present over here, that hydrogen as well as one of the Cl will be removed as HCl, and you will get CHCl2. So this is an intermediate which is very stable in nature. Okay, so this reaction will proceed with the reacting with a base, so that aldehyde group will form as a with a benzene ring. Okay, so now with the sodium phenoxide group, aldehyde group will be attacked with the ortho position. Okay, as well as later on protonation, you will get C. Na will be removed, H will be added. H. Okay, so addition of hydrogen takes place. This sodium will be removed to get aldehyde as a product. Okay, so this is regarding Reimann-Friedmann reaction. They ask how can you convert phenolic group to aldehyde group, so that you can write this reaction. So this is regarding Reimann-Friedmann reaction. So write down the reaction, copy down the reaction. So next, we are going to see the reaction of phenol with zinc dust. Okay, copy down the reaction. So next, slide 20, write as a reaction with zinc dust. Reaction with zinc dust. So directly here, phenol can react with zinc dust to give the production formation is nothing but, that is, you are going to get benzene as a product. Okay, the formation of benzene will be formed as a product along with the releasing of the zinc is there. Here you are having OH group. Okay, so what you will get as a product? So zinc oxide formation will be formed. Okay, so hydrogen will be given by oxygen with the zinc. So that is nothing but zinc oxide formation. It takes a simple reaction, that is with the zinc dust. So next, the reaction is nothing but, that is, oxidation reaction. Together we'll finish with this also. Okay, so phenol can react with chromic acid, Na2CR2O7. Okay, acidified chromic acid, or chromic acid can react. Okay, to get, so what kind of product you are going to get? Oxidation is nothing but, see, very important reaction is also. See, whenever whenever it will be kept open, when that amount will happen, it will get oxidized in the presence of A. So what will happen by that time? It can, convert into dark color. This is pink color formation will take place. Why? Because there phenol formation will take place. What is mean by phenol? Phenol is nothing but diphenol formation. Okay. So here, benzophenol will be formed as a product. So this is nothing but benzoquinone will be formed as a product. So this is, so due to the formation of this diketone, the color of phenol will convert into dextrose. So this is regarding the chemical properties of alcohols as well as phenols. So we have, I mean, the important reactions are there based on acidity as well as the naming reactions. Learn those reaction properties. Thank you.